Hello everyone. Today I will show you how to calculate wind forces according to the Bangkok Building Control Law or standard as shown in this table. And then I will show you how to define these forces in ETABS software. But before we do that, we will start by using this Excel sheet to do the calculations, okay? We will use the design wind pressure shown here, and I want you to notice that as the building height increases, as the design wind pressure increases, okay? And before we move on, let's look at this picture that shows the vertical distribution of the pressure based on this table or the values of this table. For example, for the first 10 meters, we have applied the value of 0.5. And for the elevations between 10 and 20 meters, we have assigned this value. And in this way, we need to assign the rest of the wind design pressure. Now, in order to compute the applied wind load to each floor, we need to multiply the design wind pressure height assigned to the floor itself by the length of the building by the value of the design wind pressure. And regarding the design wind pressure height assigned to each floor, we need to calculate it as the sum of half of the story height below and above. For example, if we used a fixed story height equal to 3 meters, then the height of design wind pressure at this level equals to 3 meters divided by 2 from below and 3 meters divided by 2 from above. Also, I want you to notice that there is a location that shares two design wind pressure values as shown here in this story. And for this case, we will compute the height for each assigned value and then multiplying it by its corresponding design wind pressure value. Therefore, we are just multiplying the pressure by the area to get the force. And now we need to use this table to do the calculations. Of course, we have 8 stories, each having a height of 2.85 meters. Then we can determine the elevations based on those heights. And we need to determine the wind design pressure based on those elevations and according to this table, of course. And as shown here, I have included this column named CC, which means checking if the story height can be multiplied by the wind design pressure. Or in other words, I'm trying to check if any of those floors shares two values of the wind design pressure, okay? For example, here the story number 4 and the story number 7 shares two values of the wind design pressure. I have shown you here an example based on this idea. And now the last thing that we need to determine is the force applied at the center of each floor. Of course, we need just to multiply the wind design pressure by the story height. And in this case, the story height is just equal to the height of the wind design pressure multiplied by the length of the building. And please keep in mind that the building lengths used for the forces in the X direction is the lengths of building in the Y direction. And in same manner, if we want to compute the forces applied in the Y direction, we need to use the building lengths in the X direction. And of course, we need to do this because if I put here the plan story, and if we are applying the wind pressure in the X direction, then we need to use this surface here, which is the lengths in the Y direction. While if we are applying the wind pressure here in the Y direction, we need to use the length of building in the X direction because it is the surface subjected to this pressure or loading, okay? Also, we can compute the forces as a unit of kilonewton per meter run. And in this case, we don't need to use the building lengths, okay? But in this case, we need to create a dummy beam and we need to assign the wind load as a frame load to those dummy beams, okay? But I will use this approach, which is a force applied at the center of each floor. Then we need just to define the load pattern inside ETABS, and we need to import those forces into ETABS software, okay? Let's go now to ETABS and from define, load patterns. I will name the first load pattern to be wind X. The type is wind, and we need to select here the user loads. And let's modify this load case. Now we need just to copy the values of forces in the X direction to here. And OK. And we need to create the wind load for the Y direction. And in same manner, we need to modify it. And we need to copy those forces to here. And that's all for definition of the wind loads inside ETABS software. Now we need to run the model. Okay, the analysis is finished now, and let's confirm if we have imported the wind loads correctly to ETABS software by going to the display, and we can obtain the lateral forces from this option, the story response plots, or from here, from the show tables. I will use the second one, and we need to select here the story forces, and we need to make sure that we have selected the wind load patterns here and the wind load cases. And we need to export this table to Excel. And as shown here, the shear forces have this negative sign. Therefore, let's take the absolute value of those results. And now let's select the wind load case of X direction by going to this option, the filter, selecting the wind X, choosing the location to be top or bottom, it's just the same. And we need to copy those values to the Excel we are working in. Similarly, we need to choose the wind applied in the Y direction. We need to copy those results. And let's copy both of those to here. And as shown here, the difference is zero. Therefore, we have imported the forces in a correct way to ETABS software. And before ending this video, I want just to make it clear that for the storage that shares two values of the wind design pressure, we need just to compute the height, as I have told you before, of the assigned wind design pressure. And this can be accomplished by just taking the elevation of the story plus half of the story height to determine the elevations of the starting and ending points of the height. And after that, we need to check in which range this value falls within. For example, 21.37 falls within this range. Therefore, we need to use 1.24 here. While for the second elevation, we need to use the 0.8. Therefore, to determine the height, we need just to take the difference of the 20 minus this one, it is equal to 1.375. Therefore, the 1.2 kilonewton per square meter is assigned over this height of 1.375 for this story number 7. And similarly, the 0.8 kilonewton per square meter is assigned over the 1.475 meters for the same story, which is story number 7. This is the end of this tutorial. I hope you find it useful, and please stay tuned for my next video.